Welcome back in. It is the Local and Community Issues and Answers right here with Jonathan Lawson. We're so thankful to have in our studios today Mr. Chris Mills. And we're going to be talking about drug addictions and experiences and help for people. Chris, welcome in.
Thank you.
Talking about drug addictions, there is so many people in our area that are affected by drugs and alcohol, and it's just so damaging. What could you say to people that's going through an addiction today?
As far as my own experience, there is help available. A lot of people think there's not, and there's clinics out there and this and that. And as far as my experience, that's just drug replacement is all that is. I've been totally free for over 6.5 years, working on 7 years, and there's support groups available in the community, and I would encourage anyone to get involved in one.
What about people that think, you know, that nobody can help them, or I don't have a problem, or you know, just the denial part?
Well, until they realize they do have a problem and they need help, you really can't help someone until they want to help themselves. And I was in that road and traveled down that for years. I didn't think I had a problem, and I was in complete denial. And it was until I hit my bottom, and actually my loved one showed me some tough love and allowed me, they stepped back and then quit enabling me. Like I know a lot of people do that. They enable their loved ones, and some of them actually kill them that way.
Well, you know as well as I do, once you've got this addiction in your life, you would do anything to keep the supply of drugs or alcohol or anything that's getting you that next high. You would just about do anything, rob, steal, just take off people. It just really takes you over.
Oh, yeah, I've been there.
What are things that you could say to people that are going through such a struggle right now and really trying to get free from this?
I faced a situation in my life where I knew I was going to go to prison or I was going to stop, and that was the end of my road. And it came to a point where I got involved. I had a friend that came to me and told me she knew of a group of people that could help me, and I got involved in a support group, and that's where my recovery began. But my family had to really step back and let me hit bottom and let me really suffer some consequences, because until I suffered some consequences, I wasn't willing to do anything different.
Well, you know, Chris, everywhere we look in our community, in our town, London, Corbin, Manchester, Barberville, all around this area, it's a drug epidemic. There's a problem. There's people on drugs. There's people on meth. There's people on heroin. There's alcoholics driving drunk. We've got a serious issue with this.
Listen, in the Bible, it talks about we don't deal with flesh and blood. We deal with spirits. Mm-hmm. And it's prayer. It's through a lot of prayer. And I really believe that's the reason I'm sitting where I'm at today, because there's a lot of people praying for me.
Thank God. You've got an experience and you've got a testimony that you can really be such a light to people that have an addiction today. They might be some people even listening to this going through an addiction in their life and really searching for answers.
Listen, it was a hard road to get where I was at, and still today I struggle in some days. Is the desire there to use drugs anymore? No, but a lot of the things is finding a new way to live. Mm-hmm. And I found that through some certain people that I hang out with, and I found out a lot of the recovery is based on who I hang out with, what I do, and I need to change all the things I used to do. I can't live the way I used to live and continue not to use drugs, because I will go back to using drugs again if I continue to do what I used to do. Mm-hmm. So there's a transformation that needs to go with that.
What would you say to people, especially young people, that's not tried this before, but some of their friends are trying to peer pressure them into trying that first drug or trying that first hit of meth or something like that?
Listen, it's not worth it. It's not worth it. Listen, I went through, and I just share real openly, and that's all right.
Yeah.
Listen, Jesus didn't hide his scars, so I don't hide mine either. I went through, you know, two different marriages, you know, and I was a teenager the first time I picked up. I thought, well, you know, it can't be that bad, you know, and it came to the point where I was an IV drug user shooting meth when it was over, said and done, you know, 22 years later.
Mm. And it's so devastating just to think of those years that you threw away on drugs. And, you know, I have friends to do the same thing and family to do the same thing. It's so devastating to think, look, you know, what I was into. Look what happened to me just because of that first high. Mm-hmm. You know, it really takes one time to get high on these, and then you're just so addicted you think you got to have it.
Yeah, a lot of people think it's a matter of self-will. We know he would just stop, and they would just stop. Listen, mm-hmm. It's not. It's the power of the drugs. And it'll consume your whole life. I mean, if it's easy to stop, the whole world would just stop.
Right.
You know, because I know a treatment center that's, you know, I've seen a lot of women pregnant, and, you know, and if it was that easy, women would stop for their child. You know, I really believe it's a demon. It's something more powerful than just the drug that you're dealing with.
Right. Well, like you was talking about your family, it doesn't just affect you. It affects the people around you, your family, your friends, your neighbors, your loved ones, even your children. It affects everybody because a lot of times people not seeing what they're doing to themselves, their own self-destruction, but their family seeing it, and it's breaking their heart. What are signs that we need to look out for about a loved one or a family member or a kid or something like that that are starting to get on these drugs? What's some signs?
Well, as far as my own personal experience in my life, I became real antisocial. I really didn't want to go out and travel anywhere. Didn't want to leave. You know, it's like the power of the drug. If I didn't have enough drugs to go out of town that day, I wouldn't go out of town.
Mm.
You know, I'd all come sudden become ill. I remember my son on several occasions wanting to go out and visit, go to Lexington for whatever reason. And if I didn't have enough drugs to go that day, I'd all of a sudden get ill or whatever. Money come up missing, a real secret life, different things like that. You know.
And their appearance as well.
As far as their appearance, I lost a lot of weight. Mm. I was on meth and I lost a lot of weight and I started picking up my skin. I have a picture in my phone I keep. And I'm pretty slim now. I weigh 175 pounds. I weighed 135 pounds when I got here.
Mm.
So,
well, you know, a lot of people go through the withdrawals too. You know, they try to get off this stuff, and it, some people says the withdrawals could even kill you, like your heart